Hola, friends. Can you believe it? Here we go. Chapter cinco, that would be five for non-Spanish speaking people. Great day. All right. Hey, let's take a little look here. We're going to take a starting stance here at looking at linear functions. Now, the word linear means root word linear, line. So we are going to be looking at graphing functions today that are lines, straight lines. Up, down, left, right, side to side. And our graphing method today, if you remember back chapter 1, section 8, we did a little bit of graphing functions using a table of values. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to be plugging in x values of negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2, as we did way back at the end of chapter 1. What's important today is that we have all of our functions, that they are written in what we call function form. Now, function form is when I have the function written as y equals everything else. So my goal today is to isolate the y variable, get it alone using inverse operations. Now, two ways you can have y by itself. You could have y equals everything else, or if you have everything else equal to y, either way, the y is alone. So you can have y on the left side of the equal sign or on the right side, and you are good to go. So as we look at our first example here, we have this equation here, y equals x minus 4 in function form, since y is by itself. So what I'm going to do is plug in negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2 in for x, and then figure out what the y value would be. So if I put in negative 2 for x, negative 2 minus 4 is negative 6. Negative 1 minus 4, negative 5. 0 minus 4, negative 4, 1 minus 4, negative 3, 2 minus 4, negative 2. So now I am going to graph these five ordered pairs. Again, I've got my x-axis, y-axis, and when I graph these, they should form a straight line since we are working with linear functions today. So negative 2, negative 6 is going to be 2 to the left, down 1, 4, 5, 6. So I'll start there. Negative 1, negative 5, 1 to the left, down 5. 0, negative 4 is nowhere left or right, then down 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, negative 3, 1 to the right, down 3. And then 2, negative 2 is 2 to the right, down 2. So I now have this graph here is the line y equals x minus 4. This is the visual interpretation of my chart here. Now, we could do a whole bunch of more points because lines go on forever and ever, but we are going to stick with 5 points. So as long as your 5 points do form a straight line, you know you have a good probability of having the correct graph. Example 2. We also have this equation in function form, y equals everything else. But be careful here. I have y equals 5 minus x. When I plug in negative 2 for x, this is going to be y equals 5 minus negative 2. So 5 minus x is negative 2. So that minus negative will actually turn into a plus. So 5 plus 2 will be 7. I plug in negative 1, 5 minus negative 1 becomes 5 plus 1, or 6. 5 minus 0 is 5. 5 minus 1 is 4. 5 minus 2 is 3. So negative 2, 7 is 2 to the left, up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Negative 1, 6, 1 to the left, up 6. 0, 5, nowhere left or right, up 5. 1 to the right, up 4. And then 2 to the right, up 3. And then I have dots and extending. There is the graph of my function. Example three, the final example here. You are given x equals everything else. So your equation here is not in function form. So I need to get this y alone. So I'm going to do that by moving this positive 3 away from y. So I'll subtract 3 from both sides, and I'll have x minus 3 equals y. And again, this is function form because I have the y by itself. If this messes with you, x minus 3 equals y, you can write this as y equals x minus 3. That is just fine. Either way, x minus 3 equals y or y equals x minus 3 are equivalent. So when I plug in negative 2 for x, y equals negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5. Negative 1 minus 3, negative 4. 0 minus 3 is negative 3. 1 minus 3, negative 2. And then 2 minus 3, negative 1. So we have these five ordered pairs here. Negative 2, negative 5. I'm going to go 2 to the left and then down 5. One to the left, down 4. Nowhere left or right, down 3. 0, negative 3. One to the right, down 2. Then 2 to the right, down 1. So we got my line. As follows. Hopefully you are groovy here, getting your 5 ordered pairs, x, y coordinates for each line, plugging and chugging, and then transferring over to a graph. Fly on, enjoy your. If you did notice here, we did skip the top part of the notes. We just looked at the bottom part for efficiency purposes. Have a great one.